teléfono.
We are going to talk a little about Occhiolino, the experience implementing and developing Occhiolino for a food testing laboratory. Sebastián, Javier. So during this presentation, we are going to talk first about some concepts, and then we are going to show a little bit about how it's working with Occhiolino, a functional demo. And then I want to talk a little bit about some decisions we made in order to give answers to the requirements of the laboratory. And you can stop us anytime. Be free. So, for the ones that don't know about this, we made some talks in the past, but it's always nice to remember. This is a project of GNU Solidario, the ONG that Luis is the president. And it's a free software project. We are working. Tim Bright is working in this project, the development. Also, Cilix is involved. Right there. And of course, SIAT is involved. SIAT is the laboratory in the south of Argentina. First, what is LIMS? As I said, it's Laboratory Information Management System. We have to say a word. It's not the same as LIS. It's not the laboratory system used in a medical, only medical health institutions. It's a more larger and complex project dealing with a lot of procedures and workloads. It is a GNU official package named LIMS, so all the development infrastructure is provided by the Free Software Foundation. And you can find it as LIMS, as I said. Of course, we love Triton, so we decided to build it on top of the Triton. And we interact with Triton to all the batteries that are included, including the accounting, store, and so on. And on top of that, we build all that have to do with the laboratory stuff, in a way, following the same paths or principles used in GNU Delphi. As one of the requirements of the laboratory was to follow the standards. They are already complying with these standards, the ISO and the good laboratory practice. The good news is Triton already gives and solves the measure of these requirements. I mean, the traceability and the audition of who touches this record, the timeout that already has Triton, and
modify result.
Yes, there are so much stuff that it's already covered in the platform. But of course, it will comply with all of these standards. About CIATI. CIATI means Centro de Investigación y Asistencia Técnica a la Industria. It means Center of Investigation and Assistance Industry. technical to the industry. They have 4 or 5 laboratories, different specialties: chemistry, agrochemical waste, microbiology, environment, gas, oil, and water also. They have around 60 people working, more than 30 laboratory devices, and they process 20,000 samples per year. When we talk about samples, it means that each sample will have, when you process and put the results of the sample, finally you will have a invoice to make about that line, about that sample. It will convert in an invoice line. Each service that you have in there, we will talk about that later. And you must make a report with the laboratory results of that sample. So this is the end of the chain. But we will talk about that later. So first, some links-based models that we want to show. First of all, you have the analysis and a way to group analysis, we call it a set, and a way to group sets, we call it a group. And they are all in the same table, it means analysis sets and groups, because we don't have a better name. So, for example, this is an analysis form. An analysis form with some information, but the analysis is linked with a Triton product. And the analysis can have several laboratories that can do that analysis, different methods that can implement that analysis and different process to get to the result of that analysis, and different devices that can work and to obtain the result of the analysis. As I said, this is of the type analysis. This is the simplest one. But you can, for example, search for the sets. And we have here a set that includes 4 different analyses. These are all in the same table, because we will see later that when you have to fill what are the services that you have to test for the sample, you have to choose the analysis or the set of the group from the same place. Because maybe the customer asks for a group or 2 sets and then different analysis. The last example is a group, for example. This is a group with 25 different analyses. And you can see the last one are the type sets. The previous one are the type analysis. So, this is about analysis itself. Then you have the method and devices. You already saw that you can link the method and devices to the analysis. And then you have a concept that is the product type and the matrix. Let me show you just quickly that you have different product types. For example, fresh fruit. And you have different types of, we call it matrix, that are different kinds, can be different kinds of that, but these kinds can be associated to several product types. So you have to make the link in another table that is the typification table. The typification table. In the typification table, you have a lot of information. That is the product type, the matrix, the analysis, the method, and some information of the results, the start unit of measure, quantification limits and detection limits, and other stuff. But this is the table that joins all these previous models.
This model I have created because detection limit and quantification limit dependent about the products and the matrix, because for the same analysis the limited detection is different for water, for oil, for apple, for pills, but I need, when I get my result for the product, I need to check the result, and the result is depending about the product with I get the result. So because I create this model for check the different limit for different products when the analysis is the same. Okay.
Okay, this is about some basic models that are like in the basic structure of the limbs. Then we are start dealing with the samples and that are the things that I don't know, several very known companies or companies that work with the laboratory must test his products before starting to selling or starting to export to other countries. So these companies ask CIATI to make different kind of tests. So in order to group the samples, they take to CIATI. We define a new document. It's called the entry. The entry is just a document to group the samples. But the thing to talk in this slide is that it's not only that samples are in the lines level of the entry, is that you have the fractions. Each sample can be fractioned, and you have different sequences for the entry. You have sequences for the sample, and each time you make a fraction of the sample, you have like a sub number of the sample for the fraction. And for each fraction, you can define what services you are going to do. That services are related to the analysis, the sets, and the groups we previously saw. So we have these, like, the four levels in this structure. Let me show this in how we implemented this in Triton. We have the entries document. This is the entries document. We have here a bunch of many to the samples. When we open the samples, we have a one to many to the fractions. When we open fraction, we have here a one to many to the services. At first, this was the way to encode the data, to create an entry, then create a sample, enter to the sample to create a fraction, enter to the fraction to create a service, but it was very heavy to the user to create all this drill down information. So then we are going to see that we created a wizard in order to improve all this information that the user must complete. Okay? Any questions so far? Okay. Okay, so let's I will talk to Fabio in order to show us how to work with this. First of all, he will create a new entry. We have a party, an invoice party, because there are several times that it's not the same. It's not the same party. You have the party that is the owner of the samples, but you have to invoice this to another.
Use the same design for the sale.
It's for the sale, yeah.
Yeah, leave it empty and use the default one. And
yes.
Instead of entering twice.
Good idea.
When create the sample, I selection about product type. For example, water. Matrix. Water. I have different type fraction because I have internal control about requirement about ISO, because I can create internal fraction type for get the result, and this result check for original fraction about my client.
So this is all required. Information in order to can create these four levels of the entry, samples, fraction, and service.
So when this whistle, I try to accelerate the process, because in one screen I create the samples. I create the fraction, and create the service.
Okay, there are some things here that are happening when you confirm an entry. And the first versions we send an email to the customer saying acknowledge of receipts of the samples. Now we move that to a scheduled job in order to send an email in the background, because the previous versions, when you hit the button, it delays some seconds, and now it sends in the background the emails.
Maybe you can show the results.
After that, ingress my sample, get the laboratory need to planification about what to do with sample for each laboratory. In this planification, I indicate about service analyze. Then I indicate about fraction I include in this planification, and indicate about the professional laboratory do its results. this professional laboratory received this document about the what to do.
We have using here, we are using the dashboard, right, here, in the, we call it the laboratory notebook, because for each fraction here we are seeing the services for the fraction, and we have to work a little about the, some refresh things, of the dashboard, things that maybe these days could be useful. But the idea is that maybe the user can encode the results here manually. Of course, there are other places to get results from the devices and so on. But this is a very useful form for the users, and they work a lot with this. Of course, they can filter the fractions, different fields, machine fields, and work with the services. You can filter also the lines or the services of the fraction. And have the find, once you get the results and you put all the results of the services, finally you have to send the results report to the user. I'm making this short because this is quite, it's more large, and in several steps, and we are summarizing. I have now installed a dependency to merge PDFs, because each laboratory can perform different tests on a sample, and they work totally in independent way. So maybe one laboratory has today the results and creates his results report, and another laboratory maybe it's tomorrow, but for the customer, finally you send only one results report, that it's a merge of the different reports of the different laboratories. But I think I have a problem with the PDF. Okay, any question? Okay. So now I want to show some things that for me are nice, and maybe in different implementations you will find a similar problem. And the problem is already solved in a standard Triton module most of the times. You have already examples, so we use that examples to solve the different situations here. The first one is the user, different users want different customized views of this laboratory, of this dashboard. So maybe one user doesn't need to see all these fields. So taking the example of the journals in Triton, you can define what fields to different views of these notebook fields. And when you define this, you put a sequence, so in the order of for the fields and what fields you go to, then you associate this view to the user. Okay? A second, this is something that is not in Triton, but we had to find a way to ease the process of dealing with the access groups for the users. So created like a concept that is the user role, that it's a way to group different user groups, and then you can associate a role to the user, and when you do that, it automatically creates the groups. It's only to ease the task of the administrative ID in charge of the access roles. You can see that here, user roles. The user roles, it's a container of groups. Nothing, it's quite easy. This is a curious example of how the rich text widget help us in a situation, because for the microbiology laboratory, it is a must to report, when they report the services, some words are in italic, some maybe Latin words, or I don't know, but some words must be written in italic. So one way we thought it was nice, it was to encode this using a rich text widget. So for example, if we go to analysis sets and groups, and we filter for one that is used in the microbiology laboratory. Let's find, for example, this one, and you see there are some words that are in type. So then when you print a results report, when you print a results report for the microbiology laboratory, and we see here, we parse that. I think we're going to change that in the 3.0 page. This is in 3.6, because the rich text widget changed the way to store information, but control it.
This is a reason, because
it's used generally with Relatorio.
Yes, this is Relatorio.
And insert?
This is Relatorio for one laboratory, and when you, instead of launching a report from this, you launch from the results report, it's
in macro, in the reason is microbiologic analysis composed for two forms in your names, gen and
general specific.
General specific. And for the definition for microbiology, I need to represent it in italic and only italic, and first letter for Jane is a capital, okay? Because the only one, this only one way for result include the script.
Rich text.
Another thing we have to solve, it was the need of the digital signature. In Ciati, they are already signing documents with a dongle to sign documents. And they already have some development made in Java to communicate with that. We are not talking here about GPT. It's a private company that makes this security digital signature dongles. But what they do is that when you sign with it using this, you can open it in a low reader private software, and you see like that the certificate and the digital signature. And this is a must for the Ciati customers, so we integrate this Java signer with that runs on Windows today. So we integrated this, made in a service, a twisted server that runs on that server, and Triton communicates with this twisted server, pass the PDF and the arguments, and then we grab the file and we attach the file to the report model of Triton, and then we send in another cron job, another schedule of Triton, we send these emails with the results to the customers. We have made some things in order to import the results of devices. Basically, we are not connecting directly to the devices. We are parsing files, and they are standardized the way that the devices must return information. So they have like three or four different formats, and all the devices use these formats, and you can import the files within Triton. But the idea is that you can define a new module that inherits from this instrument, and you make this instrument something and make and define a new parser for the files to load the results to the system. I don't know, maybe I can show this, but we have a mod, we have different models, Linux instrument, and then we have this custom set, generic form, generic service, and all generate from Linux results, import, and do our stuff. Okay. We have to add the unit of measure to the product variance. That's because the catalog set the uses for the products. Maybe it's the same product, but in different units of measures, but was the same product, and they have to deal with the stock. For the stock is one product only. Sorry. The accounting it's one product only, but there are different products for the stock with each with its own unit of measure. I think yesterday I hear about an anti or CXR module that does this, but I wasn't aware of that. We have made some modifications in production in order to recompute the cost, the total cost of the production once you delete some inputs or outputs. So because we were facing some troubles modifying the inputs or outputs of a production order, so now we'll recalculate the total cost of the production order. And as another example, we have created a new model for price lists, because we have the need of that price list must depend on another price list. So we created a model for that, like this. This is a price list that is direct in this case. But this one is based on the other price list. And in the lines you can be direct or also based on another price list. And of course some integration to when you confirm the entry, you already are creating invoice lines that are managed with the standalone form of the invoice lines, in order that you can grab it later and look it the way you like it. To invoice for the customers, and we use that also for the purchases, the invoice for the suppliers. I think this is what we wanted to show.
Thank you.
I need the information about I create the result. It's visible very fast for my client. Mm-hmm. Okay. I know about use private software, but I don't know the other forms about that.
Maybe I
don't see.
There is a bug on the Rollatorio Bug Tracker.
Huh?
There is a bug for that on the
Rollatorio
Bug Tracker, but...
Okay. Do you have barcode or label printers attached to the system?
Label printers?
Label printers or
yes,
barcode
yes,
printers
yes,
or something
yes,
like that.
Yes.
We work with the format, A4 format or letter format with some barcodes we are using, but also with printers, several printers that are special printers for labels. Yes, we are using that. It's only to install the barcode font on the Linux server. It is made with Rollatorio also.
Is there also a connection maybe to some analysis devices or something like that, so that the information, the results flow automatically into the system?
No.
Only
we parse the results file that those devices export. We are not dealing with direct communication, because they have, as we said, 30 devices, different brands, different products with different specifications. It's a lot of work, and it's a lot easier to parse the documents. And on another hand, there are a lot of devices that you don't have the specifications to communicate, because they only work with their private software. So you have no way to communicate with those.
So when you say you're processing the results or the analysis file, that means if you give the analysis to somewhere else, they are returning a file in a defined format.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Because the same equipment only
only communication about owner software. I can communication directly about the device. So at the moment it's only reason for import result and about the parts. Hoy, today about TXT.
Okay.
Thank
you.
Cool. I think that I have a lot of questions.
Maybe tomorrow.
we have a similar problem like the different worms. We talked this about yesterday, but I don't know if there is a communication or something between these limbs. Can you help? I don't know if it's necessary because I don't understand anything about mechanical issues, but I don't know if you are planning to
Yes, it was one of the main goals. And not at this moment because CIATI is a laboratory for food industry. So because this is like an implementation project for CIATI, and we doesn't have the need right now to do the communication with head, but of course the idea is to the ones that a large hospital or that has a large laboratory inside, and for sure it will deal with this kind of system, and we will have to do the link with that.
From the last time you have shown me this project, it was at the very beginning, and now it has evolved a lot. So congratulations on that. But how close to the end? Of course, a software project never really ends. But how close to a first deliver of this project you are, or it's already delivered?
We are doing heavy testing in CIATI, and we should go live 1st of January next year.
Of 2018.
And of course, later, once we are leaving CIATI and start, of course, there will be a lot of code to touch and to solve different things. And then we have to plan some first release of things, because of course right now it's a development repository, and we are updating the GNU repository once in a while with the CIATI project repository.
And another question about the modularity. How did you spread all that functionality between modules?
This is, I think, one of the most difficult things to do, and there are times that we can't think, okay, we have to do this model, and there are times during the project that we must end because we have the CIATI pressure also. So right now we have this in several modules. The project lets limbs, for example. So we have some modules extends are named in the same way as Triton because they extend maybe some of the Triton based module. And some like the instruments, the digital sign, or I don't know. Of course, the larger one is limbs. And there are some things in limbs that must be put it in different modules maybe. But I think that will be in second stage of the project. Another one? Hello?
Yo tengo una pregunta.
No, no, no.
I can understand why a price list is relation with another price list. It's that you. Why you need to do that? I can understand the functionality.
Yes. El tema es así. Nosotros teníamos una lista de precios única. Uh-huh. Está. Pero después cada cliente tenía una lista de precios particular.
Ah,
que tenía que tener como base la lista original, 20% más, 3% más, 15% más, ¿ok? Esa era una problemática. A eso se le agregaba que si había una oportunidad de negocio, nosotros le podíamos ofrecer determinados productos a otro precio distinto. Por eso definimos dos formas de evaluación. Basada en donde yo me tomo la que estoy basándome, y en una cotización directa, en donde yo puedo decir, este es el precio directo. Entonces tomamos el módulo base de lista de precios, pero no me servía como estaba por esta problemática, digamos, ¿no? Por eso se hizo ese custom, si quieres llamarlo de alguna manera.
Basically they have one price list, but then they have like different price lists for different customers, and they have to increase or decrease the original price list for each customer. So the customer price lists are based on the standard one and other things also.
Another one?
Yeah.
Okay. Such module should not be limited to lists, the prices of price lists. It should be.
Yes,
I guess it depends on nothing inside the links system. So it could be
you're right, it's not related to links,
yeah.
But it's part of this project. I don't know. We have to find a name in convention. But it's hard to find names.
Ready?